say, Teddy Edwards, our guest leader tonight, has been one of the boss tenors since the late 1940s. Yet through most of the 50s, he became virtually one of the forgotten men of jazz. Yeah, but before getting into this, let's have the Teddy Edwards Sextet tell us about a cellar dweller. Charlie Parker, Howard McGhee, Dexter Gordon, prime contributors to modern jazz, each in his own way, and key influences in Teddy Edwards' life. Teddy was 18 when he first heard the astonishing music of the Yardbird. That was in Detroit back in 1942. Like Bird, Teddy was playing alto sax at the time. The impact of Parker's genius on Teddy's life was to help shape his whole musical future. Howard McGhee also helped determine Teddy's future. When Teddy moved to Los Angeles 2 years later, Howard invited Teddy to join his new band, but he insisted that he change to the tenor sax. Well, Teddy was ready, and a future boss tenor was born. Dexter Gordon. Long, tall, Dexter. In 1948, Dexter was acknowledged as one of the top tenor men in jazz, but his eminence was to be challenged that year by 24-year-old Teddy. The challenge to Dexter was a hard-fought battle of the tenors on a 1948 record called The Duel. Also recorded on that same date was Teddy's well-known Blues in Teddy's Flat. Well, shortly after this, a new movement in jazz, sometimes called the West Coast School, began to stir in Southern California. West Coast jazz and Teddy Edwards just didn't gel. In his own words, I guess I just didn't fit in. What was Teddy's music? Basically, it's the same today as it was then, swinging hard. And listen now to a fine example of the Edwards approach as Teddy and his sextet play the most requested selection in their book, Teddy's own composition, Sunset Eyes.
Sure got that message, Teddy. I'm sorry this thing pulled loose. going to play for us next?
Well, we'd like to do an instrumental version of a tune that was written as a ballad with a lyric. It's called Afraid of Love.
Yeah.
I'll play the first chorus, and Richard Boone will play some very interesting upper register trombone on the bridge.
Okay.
And he'll leave it to Freddie Hill, who rounds it out with a very fine trumpet coda. I'd like you to meet the rest of the guys that are supporting us all. Our pianist, John Houston.
Hey, John.
Stan Gilbert, bass.
Hi, Stan. How are you?
And young Doug Sides at the drums.
Oh, thank you very much, Teddy. Here we are, Afraid of Love.
Next number are the same. On the record, though, it was concocted by the Teddy Edwards Quartet. Right now, the Cooks are Teddy Edwards Sextet. Listen closely for the exchange of dialogue between Teddy's tenor, the trombone, and the trumpet. It's a sort of question and answer period. Then when you hear that dramatic drop in volume, you'll know it's to set up Teddy's final solo. Right now, let's hear Teddy mix up a bowl of that good gravy. Thank you.
Teddy, come on over here. Man, it's been a real pleasure for us having you on the jazz scene. You guys are really cooking. You're just sounding beautiful. Have a seat. Have a seat. Say, you're keeping pretty busy these days in the recording studios and clubs, right?
Well, things are going on pretty good. I made two albums recently that I'm very proud to be a part of.
Well, tell us what they are.
Well, Swinging with Humes, Miss Helen Humes, on Contemporary Records. And another wonderful album, You Better Believe It, Gerald
sure
Wilson
do.
Big Band on World Pacific Records.
Oh, man, that sounds wonderful. Hey, you know, I really dug the number you guys are going to close the show with. What's that called?
Velvet Mist.
Oh, that sounds like a ballad title.
Well, it was originally intended to be a ballad, but after trying it up tempo, we decided to leave it there.
Well, it sure works. Well, you go count them off.
Good enough.
Wrapping it up, here's Teddy, the sextet, and a beautiful ballad that's now jumping, Velvet Mist.
For playing and you for watching and listening. Oscar Brown Jr. Later.
Thank you.